Yeah, welcome back.
Glad to be here. So let's get these updated. On the left, you've got Tim Mueller.
Mueller.
On the right, you got Kevin Sanders playing Green Black Delirium.
Not sure what Tim is playing. It's Green Black something.
Is he? All right.
Yeah, we got a Green Black Mirror here.
Green Black Mirror, the old Golgari mirror.
These are,
I feel like a Golgari mirror would be very dirty. Like, it's in the sewer, and it's, you know.
I mean, not all Golgari exists in the sewer. They just also exist in the sewer. Okay.
Right,
so Sanders is going to keep his 7. He's got a pretty solid one, I feel.
All right.
He's a snake short of probably the best thing he wants to do. Maybe an extra land, I don't know. But he's in good shape.
All right. Let's see where Tim's at.
Tim, on the other hand, I don't see many cards. He might be on, like, the Jund list. I'm not sure.
We're going to find out. He drew a forest, and here's a Evolving Wilds. So
the worst Evolving Wilds.
Evolving Wursts, apparently. And he's going to go get an additional forest, so he's committed to having some green mana.
That was a really weak joke. I just want to let you know.
What?
Evolving Wursts? That was bad.
I was trying to gloss over it.
I'm just...
I knew it was bad.
Holding your feet to the fire here.
My feet are to the fire. All right, so we have a forest in the swamp. So we're definitely Golgari something. Golgari Basics. That's a pretty swamp. It's got a nice sunset.
Yeah, it's an all right one. It's got the weird little maze thing that all the Kaladesh lands have.
All right, here's a Rishkar.
Rishkar!
Trigger?
Man, triggering this Grim Flayer has got to feel like the best thing in the world here.
Oh, man, especially when you see two lands.
Land, Kalitas, when you've already got three lands in play, and I think at least one more in hand. I didn't see what his past couple draws have been. He's got two cards in hand. So it looks like it's just been... No, he's got four in hand. Yeah, he's got more lands.
Yeah, it's a shame Grapple that the Grim Flayer doesn't...
Man, this is...
...get played more often. All right, so we have creature, land, artifact... Or creature, artifact... Is that... What is that under the ballista?
Another Grapple the Pass.
Okay, it's just... It's got a darker printing.
So we have creature, land, artifact, instant. But we need to get to 5 to get this Ishkana online. And even then, Kevin Sanders' creatures are going
to
be much larger.
Oh, we need to get to 5 mana.
Yes.
All right. Yes. Check.
Check.
All right. There's a Tireless Tracker on 3.
Pretty solid card in this matchup. Not a solid card here, I feel.
Concur. You could trade it for the Grim Flayer. I don't think Sanders is going to offer that. I don't think that's a potential thing that this tracker can do.
So he could tap the Grim Flayer to power out this Kalidus and swing in with the Rishkar, which I feel like is probably the optimal play. Like, you're willing to trade a Rishkar for a Tireless Tracker and get a zombie.
Right. He's done his work. He's distributed his counters. He's generated some mana.
And you're definitely losing a counter there. But then you have a board with zombie... Kalidus. See, I would have held on to this Fatal Push, but, I mean, this is the most aggressive line. Maybe he just wants to end the game very quickly now that he knows that Ishkana is on the menu.
Sure, that's a possibility.
If that's the case, he definitely wants to keep this Verdurous Gearhulk on top, as that's going to end the game very quickly. And this Kalidus is just not...
Yeah, it's
exciting.
Not coming down this turn.
Well, it's definitely not coming down this turn, but I'm thinking it's not coming down.
I will put both these lands into the graveyard.
Maybe
I can't imagine wanting any more mana in this game.
I mean, does he have one? So you want one more if you're going to have the Verdurous Gearhulk on top.
I mean, you just tap one of your creatures.
Not if you want to be aggressive, ma'am.
I do not... Okay, so if I wait two turns...
Okay, so he has another push in hand, so he keeps the Evolving Wilds on top, which is reasonable. But if I'm making this play, then I'm 100% playing the Kalidus on my turn.
Sure.
So this is kind of the Kevin Sanders folly, as we'll call it.
Where he plays half of each line.
Right, where he like makes a very strong play towards one line, and then just kind of backtracks a little bit.
Right, decides against it.
Luckily, this deck does not have any Avacyns in it for him to misplay.
Right, Avacyn is Kevin's favorite card to misplay, really. Okay, so no plays for Tim here. So this Fatal Push line has really failed.
Yeah.
When do you abandon a specific line? So, the decks I tend to play are very aggressive, and they only do one thing. You know what I mean? As long as you're being aggressive, you're more than happy to be there.
Sure.
Whereas I feel like this green-black Delirium deck has a little bit more finesse to it.
Absolutely. So, he just got two to slaughtered. His options were sacrifice the Grimflayer, sacrifice the Rishkar, or fire up this Hissing Quagmire and sacrifice that.
Uh-huh.
Sacrificing the Rishkar there was the right call because he didn't attack with it.
Okay.
Like, for some reason, he was keeping it back. I don't know what he was playing around in the combat step against green-black.
Yeah, Tim didn't really have anything developing for him.
Yeah, that game was not a good one for Tim.
That's the one thing I've noticed about this standard format is that your deck has to develop the board. The game is played on the board for sure.
Yeah, that's definitely the case. You need to block, you need to attack, or you need to make an infinite number of cats to do it for you.
Right. I was real excited after the last Pro Tour. Like, the finals was literally a Grixis control deck versus a blue-white control deck.
The last Pro Tour? Or the previous Pro Tour. Because the last Pro Tour was Mardu versus Mardu.
Oh, you're right, you're right. The previous one from that. And I just thought it was a fantastic... I was like, oh, good, we're going to play, you know, kind of a control metagame, which anybody that knows me knows I would never touch a control deck to save my life.
Right.
However, I love those kind of metagames because it opens up deck building for the aggro players.
Yeah, because
you have to like build the right kind of aggro deck to match poorly, like match better against their removal spells, and you know it makes it interesting.
Yeah,
this format has not ended up that way after the vehicles Pro Tour. Everything's on board.
Yeah, it's a bit of a cluster.
Bit of a CF. Ideally, you have a metagame where both decks exist.
Correct.
We got a strong control deck and a strong aggro deck.
So I think the problem with the previous format was that the control decks, the actual control decks endgame was Emrakul.
Uh-huh.
And it wasn't like a blue control deck, so they weren't okay with it.
I see.
So how do you feel about these the sideboards here for the green black deck? What are the big cards?
The big cards sideboarding in here are your... I'm assuming we're all in on Fatal Pushes. I really couldn't tell you. I haven't really been paying... I've been focused on the two big decks of the metagame. These green-black decks have really kind of...
Well, they're all over the place.
Escape my radar.
Sure. So you want to prepare for the grindy game.
Right.
So Tireless Tracker is good. Verdurous Gearhulk's great because it ends the game on its own. It can end the game on its own.
Right.
Immune to push, obviously.
Right.
A couple planeswalkers will usually come in, so like a couple Obnix.
Okay.
Obnix list is really good. I've seen a smattering of Kaladesh Nissa, who's been pretty solid.
Oh, yeah.
So you have a lot of options. I think the name of the game is to go bigger without completely abandoning the early game. It seems like, yeah, both of these players on the Delirium game plan, so you get a little bit less wiggle room. Obviously, Ishkana is just atrocious here. Like, it doesn't do anything.
Right.
But you don't really have an equivalent endgame plan to bring in.
Yeah, my thought process would be that your sideboard's a little limited because of so much of it being taken up by like the vehicles and the Saheeli decks.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's definitely the case.
Like, any artifact removal you have for the vehicles decks, you know, can't get brought in. It's pretty irrelevant.
In this particular instance, yes. There are some green-black decks that run, like, Harvester.
Sure.
And, like, Ballista is still there, and there's always clue tokens. Obviously, you don't want to blow up a clue token with an artifact spell, but if you're using it as a way to get a gremlin off of... release the gremlins, and that's perfectly fine.
Sure. All right, so Sanders, I think, is going to keep this six.
Two lands.
Fatal push on top, too.
And a fatal push on top, yeah.
That's good.
Kind of awkward that his one land is a forest.
Is he going to push this fatal push to the bottom? All right.
Yeah, because if he's going to cast it, he's going to have to pop this Evolving Wild to get the forest, or to get the swamp.
I just want to get this, I want to get opposing Grim Flayers.
Yeah, I mean...
That's my worry for the first three turns.
Yeah, it's reasonable.
All right.
I don't know what else is in his hand. He might have another push in his hand or something like that, but... we also don't know that Tim is playing Grimflayer. We didn't see any game one.
Sure.
Although if he's already on the Delirium, like the hard Delirium game plan, then I would assume so. And there we are.
Yeah, I mean, I assume if there's an Ishkana, there's a Grimflayer. And here's opposing Grimflayers.
Yeah, this is rough for Sanders because he doesn't want this Grimflayer to hit him, but he also doesn't want to give up his Grimflayer.
Well, I mean, if I'm Tim, I'm pushing it or I'm grasping it or whatever. I think Grimflayer advantage is huge. It's an axis you definitely want to fight on.
Oh, yeah.
And he has an additional one in hand.
Yeah,
so maybe he can offer the trade.
I don't know if he has removal. I don't really see anything, but I can't really see several of the cards in his hand. And he's flicking a bunch of lands and a second Grimflayer around.
Interesting. So he's going to offer the trade.
Yeah. That couldn't have gone better for Kevin. Top decks the push.
Here's a push.
No third land.
Wow. And Kevin, I'm wondering why Kevin blocked there. He has a Blossoming Defense in his hand.
Well, he can't let Tim's Grimflayer hit because it'll turn on its own Delirium and then just becomes a 4-4 and just... wildly unmanageable.
Sure. Oof.
Mind Rack Demon is going to be a hard one to deal with.
Alright, so he's only at two cards, so it's going to be a race to the bottom really easily here. Here's a Ballista.
Ballista's not a bad draw here. The reason being, you can pair a Ballista up with a Grasp of Darkness
to kill
this demon if you need to.
But yeah, you just get the race at 4 damage apiece.
Right. This is not currently a race that Tim's winning, although he only has to turn on Delirium.
So Tim should be at 16.
If I have another demon here, I'm snapping it off, by the way.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah. I want to fill that graveyard up for sure. This is an interesting place to be.
We're going to traverse, so we're going to add a sorcery. Just need an instant now, and if he has any kind of instant speed removal for this Ballista, I'm just firing it off. I mean, it's not great, but...
Sure.
It's going to shut off the 4 damage a turn. It's going to clear the path. Sanders is stuck on two lands. Doesn't really have any action here.
Yeah.
It looks like he's got to grapple with the pass. I would just fire this off now.
Yeah. I might have fired that off at my upkeep. Does that work the way I want it to?
I'd have to read Mind Rack Demon, but I don't know that it really matters here.
The grapple makes him delirious.
And if he didn't have...
And he gets back a Grimflare.
Oh, man, yeah, this is going to be good. So if he didn't have the grapple or he didn't have the traverse, then I wouldn't have grappled during the upkeep.
Okay, yeah, he could have drawn the grapple. Alright, Sanders still just on two land. This is not good.
Alright, he's just going to take 8 here.
Yeah, so Sanders is at 16.
He's going to go down to 8. Oh, man. He's going all the way down.
Yeah, yeah, Sanders is going to die enough. Here really quick.
Going to die real quick.
Real quick. Real quick. Yeah, that hand just didn't develop. I think it was a solid keep with two lands. With some manipulation, but the hand in general didn't develop the way we thought it would.
Yeah, he needed to definitely hit runner-runner lands there, and it just didn't work out for him.
Well, sometimes the things, they don't work out for you.
Oftentimes.
Well, in my life. Sometimes. Just more often than not. We didn't see any real sideboard action there either.
Yeah, like you suppose, there's not a lot of room for sideboard when you're playing in a format dominated by two decks. You have to be able to beat green-black. Originally did pretty well against the Mardu deck, but now that they've kind of leveled up and are using these oaths, which green-black can't really interact very well with.
Right.
And planeswalkers. It's been an uphill battle for these green-black decks, for sure.
Absolutely. Which is, it's a shame. I think Grimflare is a super fun card to play. It's obviously very powerful.
Oh, yeah.
But in order to harness that power, you have to make specific decisions.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, the lines on turns 3 through 5 to, like, get it to 4-4 and to, like, have that trigger happen multiple times. Are, like, really interesting.
Yeah, I don't think the right cards exist to be able to make those decisions right now in the current metagame. I think more often than not, because the other two, like the two main decks of the format, are so powerful, that your play is dictated and relegated to just responding to what they're doing. I don't think you're in the driver's seat in any of those matchups at that point of the game.
Sure.
Some dueling quagmires here. They're just going to hiss at each other from across the battlefield. Grimflare.
Flan.
Turn 2 for Sanders. Oh.
Here is Traverse.
Hopefully this is for a swamp and a fatal push. Otherwise, this Grimflare is coming home. I do see the fatal push in hand.
All right, so if Forest is the...
He might have the swamp in hand.
Right.
You definitely don't want this Grimflare to connect. That is not a winning proposition.
Negative. All right. So he's... This isn't good. He's let Sanders untap. Now, I don't know if he reads Sanders for Blossoming Defense, but that card definitely exists. And here's the Grimflare connecting anyway.
Looks like land, creature, and artifact potentially here. As I saw, land, ballista, I believe.
Ballista. Yeah, there's... Man... Got to be hard to.
So I know he's got a Kalidus in his hand. I'd imagine there are some board states in this matchup where Kalitas is pretty good, but I think overall it's not a great card in this matchup.
Here's Liliana.
Liliana's pretty solid.
This is interesting. So Sandra's is going to Blossoming Defense here, and what this is going to do is I think it lets him kill Liliana. If he chooses to play this Ballista for two, he can deal two damage to Tim, and then the Grim Flayer is going to be a 4/4, and he can kill Liliana.
Right. That's definitely a line.
I'm very okay with that line.
Yeah, that line's fine. Instead, we're going to run out this Kalitas.
Yeah, see, this doesn't excite me, because Liliana's still on the board. My Grim Flayer is still going to become...
Yeah, you've got a Kalitas on the board
when
there's...
Too small to become... You know what I mean?
Right.
It needs power to become big.
It does need power to become big. That is a true statement.
Well, it needs power to get the trigger, which is going to aid it in becoming the largest it can be.
I agree.
So I just feel like we're behind now.
Yeah, I feel like if you weren't going to give your Grim Flayer Delirium, then Blossoming Defensing it in response to the Lily activation is kind of a waste.
And yeah, you've all right. Well, I can't say. Oh, jeez.
So we've got dueling Kalitases.
Oh, this is interesting. So now, gosh, if he's got Verdurous Gearhulk here, it's...
Well, he's got Ballista on for two. Shoot
Tim.
Yeah, shoot Lily twice. And then Fatal Push the Kalitas.
Exiling it to get a zombie.
Swing the one from Kalitas at Lily.
Finishing the Lily.
And four from the Grim Flayer, who is now delirious, at Tim.
Getting a trigger. Yeah. The player on the play has won all these games.
Yeah.
Absolutely,
and it's so important to get out in front. That's true of any matchup in this format. Like, being on the play is very, very important.
Sure.
That's part of the reason why Fatal Push is so good, is it kind of lets you battle from behind a little bit.
Right. Alright, so he's chosen to deal two to Tim.
Oh, he does get a zombie here.
Well, yeah, Tim gets a zombie. Interesting, because since the Ballista was
since it went to exile, the Grim Flayer
was still a 2/2, and Tim could have killed it there. I wonder if he recognized that.
Yeah, I guess not.
Interesting. I think he's now realizing it. So while the standard format might be a little like one or two dimensional right now, it has a fairly large bit of intricacy in the situations like that we just saw. Like, that's a pretty intricate play.
Yeah.
And we're seeing another bit that changes this board state. Tim just played two cards and made a huge comeback. Like, he is as on the board as Kevin is now.
If not more so.
Right.
I would have personally fired up this, or put these counters on the zombie.
Right.
To, like, get in that turn, but this is fine.
I might have got in that turn before playing anything to see if he wanted to trade zombies.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not
because
crazy about trading zombies.
You're in a pretty strong
yeah.
blocking position here.
Right, and if he grows the Kalitas, you're a little bit less so.
Right.
So, Sanders' hand, he's drawn another Ballista. And has, I don't know what card that is in his hand. Can't tell. whereas Tim's got another Lily at least.
This is interesting. So if I'm Sanders, I think I'm playing the Ballista for just putting one counter on it, attacking in with all my guys, and then being willing to sack the zombie to Kalidas because I can deal a damage with the Ballista turning, making my Grimflayer delirious.
Okay.
Yeah, there's some interesting things that can happen here.
And if he does that line, then Tim doesn't get a free block on the Flayer with the Constrictor.
Right.
Although he can certainly double block with the Rishkar and Zombie.
Hide your tables. It's flipping Jake Valentine back here.
Jake flips the table. For those of you not...
not in the know.
Not in the know.
And we've been giving people nicknames in the last 2 weeks, so...
Alright, so Sanders is just going to pass. Not interested in being aggressive. And with Tim at 16, that might not be a bad call.
And with Walking Ballista on the board, it might not be a bad call either, because the longer you sit back on that, the better off you are. It can grow and grow and grow.
Absolutely. It doesn't look like it's going to pay off very well for him, because I believe I saw another Lily in Tim's hand. And that's going to spell disaster for Kevin at sacrifice.
Disaster. It spells it, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Well.
Well. Looks like a Noxious Gear Hulk in hand as well.
Ooh.
And Tim's just got so much heat.
Yeah. Man, Tim's...
the Liliana line here is just... I feel too good to pass up if that is a Liliana in hand.
I want a Noxious Gear Hulk down this Kali... I want to figure out how to...
how about a Grasp? Yeah, that doesn't feel great.
So Grasp sacks the Zombie. Kalidas is at a 2-2. Interesting.
He's a 1-2. He's a Squire at the moment.
Is he a 1-2 at the moment?
Yeah.
All right.
So simply a Squire.
So Liliana can't kill him.
But Liliana can kill this Walking Ballista, which is pretty important here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I think getting that Walking Ballista off takes away free menacing for Kevin. They could get out of hand very quickly.
Right. It takes her up.
I'm not sure what the plan was with this Grasp of Darkness.
Yeah, I might have used it as a combat trick there. Play Liliana, target the Walking Ballista, get in with my guys, and then when he's obviously gonna block with Kalidas and maybe sack the guy to it.
Right.
Or like sack block the zombie and then sack it to Kalidas before it dies.
Mm-hmm.
And that's gonna present your opportunity to grasp his Kalidas down.
Sure. So Tim could attack with the Constrictor here. It's not a great attack, because it leaves you open to your Lily dying next turn.
Right, I would pass.
Yeah, I don't think there are any good attacks here. Swing for 4. Taking Sanders down to 17. He had gained a life off of the Kalidas previously. Sanders with a Grasp of his own now in hand. That was a pretty good top deck. If he can untap with this Liliana, he is in great shape.
Man, I would block I'd double block the Grimflayer and just take the Cletus.
Yeah.
So outside of dying, I'm not too worried about, like, life totals. Like, if Sanders goes to, like, a gajillion.
Right, you're going to grind him out eventually.
Right.
So if you double block the Grim Flayer.
Yeah.
You open yourself up to get blown out by removal.
Right. This isn't worth it.
I don't mind this block, actually. So this is hedging. If he wants to spend the removal spell on the zombie token to kill the Lily, that's fine. He's just spent, like, a removal spell to kill a Lily. Like, that's reasonable. But you have two solid creatures on the board. You've got this Noxious Gear Hulk coming down to take out this Kalitas next turn.
So, like, say he has the removal spell, right?
Yeah.
And you double block.
Yep.
Then he's used the removal spell to save his Grim Flayer, not kill Liliana.
Save his Grim Flayer.
And you're going
to deals one to Lily, kills your snake, kills your zombie, gets a zombie of his own. I mean, this is just best case scenario. So he gets to keep his Lily. He loses a zombie. End. He sells a removal spell in hand. And that ain't great, but we've got a Noxious Gear Hulk coming down next turn to take out this Kalitas.
Yep.
And then we can throw everything we want in front of this Grim Flayer.
Sure.
Who is going to be huge, apparently, as Sanders has traversed for a Verdurous Gear Hulk.
How much life did Tim lose there? I got...
Tim lost 5.
Well, no, because Liliana had targeted Kalitas.
Okay, so he should have lost 3?
Yeah, I'm not sure. That's all right.
No, Liliana targeted the Ballista.
Oh, you're right. You're right.
Whoa, we're plussing on Kalitas. Don't agree with that unless we're off of the Noxious Gear Hulk plan.
Or on the Verdurous Gear Hulk plan with the...
We drew the other Gear Hulk.
All right, so I'm putting...
2 on the Gear Hulk.
3 on the Gear Hulk.
Well, a total of 3. This is fine.
This is the targeting, and then they're all going to get doubled.
They're not going to get double. They're all going to get plus one.
Okay, they're all going to get plus one. Very nuanced.
Grasping a Pima. All right, so 2 each on these guys.
Right.
So we've got a 6/7 snake and a 6/6 construct.
Whew. We've got.
So we know Verdurous Gear Hulk is coming down next turn. A little bit less impressive because he doesn't have a snake to complement it, but even still, this could be all the difference.
Yep, this could be the road less traveled by. Makes all the difference.
Let's see how he distributes these counters is a really big deal.
Okay. So I'm a fan of getting all my counters onto this Grim Flayer.
Okay.
So then you get to attack in with this 8/8 trampler.
Mm-hmm.
Both creatures block. You obviously kill the snake. And you get a zombie so that your Kalitas can be big next turn. Like, even bigger than it's going to be.
Okay.
I'm a huge fan of that line.
Yeah, that's definitely a reasonable line. And to do that, you have to make it an 8-8.
Right.
Putting them all on Kalidus.
All right, so we're going to stand behind the lifelink. We're big on lifelink right now.
So Sanders is at 22. Tim's at 11. I don't know that I don't attack here. So you've got a 9 power creature, 10 toughness. Like, you're definitely going to trade one for one with one of his creatures, but you gain a ton of life. You get to choose the snake. It's just a huge swing.
Well, no, because the Cletus got targeted by Liliana.
Oh, okay, so it's only an 8 power creature. I'm sorry, a 7.
Right.
7 power, so it was a 7-9?
Right.
It's still the same thing. You get to eat the snake.
Right, well, no, here's the thing. I'm way more interested in my Grimflare dying than my Cletus dying.
Oh, yeah.
Because if Kalidus dies, then Grimflare can be targeted by push 100% of the time.
Yeah.
Kalidus takes a little bit more effort. I'm going to roll this die around in our hands, make sure all the sides are still there. Make sure we're not living in some sort of...
fantasy land.
Or, like, you know, black hole type situation where one of the sides got spaghettified off of our... perceivable reality.
Okay. I don't know if spaghettified is the word, but... Alright.
If one side of a die were to meet the event horizon of a black hole, it would immediately become spaghettified and undetectable to our perception. Our naked eye perception. I don't know if we have instruments that could detect it.
I agree. I'm just debating the word spaghettify.
No, that's an actual it's a term in astrophysics.
Spaghettify.
Yeah, I'm not even kidding. Oh, good.
All right. Look it up. Spaghettify is the word of the day. So now Sanders is going to sit back on this lifelink. He can't swing in because there's a hissing quagmire. I guess if he has a removal spell, he's in good shape, but... all of Tim's creatures are too big for this Grimflayer to get in there in a reasonable manner. Spaghettification, sometimes referred to as the noodle effects. Who'd have thought? Okay. Spaghettified. So now Tim has his 6 mana.
Yeah, and now this... Kalatos is not long for this world. I can't imagine coming up with another target.
Don't shrink the Kalidus before.
Yes, let's target Grimflare.
Or just nothing.
Oh, we're going to roll off a couple and get something back. So we have an Obnixilus from some sort of box set or...
Yeah, that's Nissa versus Ob.
Okay. All right. Yeah, and he's going to gain 10.
All of the life.
So much. So much life.
Bunch of life.
All right, that's Sanders' graveyard. I'm glad that's not his hand, because that would have been a bad situation if that's his hand.
Yes.
And he passes with 6 mana off.
Sanders' hand is a lone Kalidus, so he can replace it, but...
All right. And so that zombie token's a real thing here, too.
Did we just pass the turn? Why are we passing the turn?
I'm not sure.
What is this?
Listen, man.
What is this?
What is this? What is this?
So, I mean, you can hit Sanders for 6, and he 1-for-1s you on one of your guys.
I can't imagine this. I mean, holy smokes. Alright. It's the untap. Tim's really looking for a Mindrak Demon.
I mean, a Minarak Demon makes this easy mode. But I don't think you need easy mode here. I think you've just got the game. You just need to pull the trigger.
You're not wrong. You're not wrong, John. Yeah, just start attacking. I think he needs to realize that the Winding Constrictor has done its duty.
It has done some duty.
It's done work, man.
Absolutely has.
So
we're going to pop a clue, looks like. Oh, we could play this card. Nope, pop a clue.
All right, pop a clue.
Drawing a fatal push and fatal pushing this Kalitas. What I tell you.
Holy smokes. Will you say the woman of my dreams is going to walk into this room?
I don't work like that.
All right.
I can only say it if it's already going to happen.
Holy smokes, that was nice. All right, so now we're getting frisky.
We're ready.
Get the snake in there.
Yeah, that snake is...
That snake is itching.
Yeah, the snake wants some action.
Here's the thing. He needs to understand that the snake and Liliana have done plenty.
Yeah, get the snake in the grass done. And let's call it a day. That represents 6 more damage to Sanders' face if he wants to double block it.
Well,
which is worst-case scenario for you.
The Gearhulks, one's trampling, the other one's menacing.
Yeah.
And so, I mean, they represent, what, 9 total?
11? 11 total, that's 6 and 5. So Sanders is going to go down to 11.
Oh, jeez. And that snake could have just been so much more. I mean, the snake's guaranteed a block there.
Yeah, so if he's not willing, or he's not forced to block the Gearhulks, he can...
Did Liliana do nothing last turn?
Sure looks like it.
All right. Because it went down the turn before.
Yeah. Just not interested in plussing. Another Verdurous Gearhulk. That's a nice draw.
Here I want to be all on the Grim Flare.
All on the Gear Hulk. All
right.
Putting them all on one creature is a big deal here because it lets you block the Grim Flare. Or, I'm sorry, the Verdurous Gear Hulk.
All right, so we shortcutted there. We didn't put the clue into play, but it's fine. Just keeping the viewers at home up to date. So we are revolted. We're head on board.
Activate.
Yeah, let's get a quagmire
and then turn literally everything sideways. Let's shrink this 8/8.
Yeah, shrink the 8/8 to an 8/6.
So it can't profitably.
Yeah, it doesn't get anything. To profitably
6/7.
Jeez.
So it can still profitably block the Gear Hulk. The Verdurous Gear Hulk.
That's 1,000,000% fine with me.
Yeah, because then he is taking 7.
Get a Quagmire 13, involved.
A billion. Yeah, get in there. You're at 21 life.
You're
time to be a man.
Life. Yeah, Liliana doesn't. Here's the thing. The longer this goes.
All right, where are we plussing? Didn't he just move it to 2 to plus it?
I think he did. All right,
so where are we plussing? Come on, give me a point.
No. Yeah, we were talking about where... Okay, so he gets the big guy. Please, just get the Quagmire in there. Come on.
Come on, bro.
He wants to preserve this Liliana for some... I mean, I can't... I need to figure out why.
Yeah, there's no way that Sanders attacks the Liliana because then he's just dead on the swing back.
Right.
The best defense here is a good offense. Come on, Tim. Get in there.
I lost in the semifinals of PTQ for this reason.
What the hell is this?
Like, okay.
This is the most embarrassing thing I've ever seen in my life.
He's actually just throwing this card away. Because Sanders has a 6/7 right now.
Well, that thing is a 7/6.
What's happening?
This is the most embarrassing attack I've ever seen in my life.
Are you embarrassed for
it? I am embarrassed for Tim. Just push, man. Just push. But here we are. I guess he's worried about the third Verderous Gear Hulk off the top. I don't know, man. Well,
I can't. Well, here's the thing. So
Tim has successfully survived another turn.
If you attack with everything, Sanders has to block because he's at 11.
Yeah.
And then
he has to block a lot.
Right, he has to do a lot of blocking. And he can't attack you even if he draws. So he has to block, so things are going to die. And then he has to. I just can't imagine the draw that gets him back in the game to deal him. Let's him deal 21 damage.
Damnation.
All right, here's another. All right, clue. Sacrifice the clue. Two counters. Draw a card.
All right, let's shrink something. Probably a Grim Flayer.
So now there's no excuse. Now you're out of excuses. It goes to 3. Oh,
no, it would die. It's at 2.
It was at 2, and he wants to go up to shrink something, so it was okay. Goes to 3.
Turn your guys to the side. Guys,
you can turn
to the sides.
You can turn to the right. You can turn to the left. He's chosen to the right. He's chosen the right.
He's just turn the snake sideways.
Man.
Oh, goodness gracious. What are we doing? So, like, this is an actively bad block. Or a bad attack. So he gets to kill both of your guys, and one of his guys lives. Like, it's not great.
So Sanders has blocks such that he's going to kill both.
So you can double block the Gear Hulk and then double block the other Gear Hulk with Hissing Quagmire.
Okay.
But he's not even forced to block them both. Draws a Ruinous Path, which is great here.
Man, Ruinous Path is fantastic. Get this. I wonder if you can make a guy with it.
Yeah, he's got 8 mana.
No, I know, but I'm wondering if you could do that and live. On the snake.
I don't think you want the snake. I think you just want the Gear Hulk, because Gear Hulk has trample. So worst case scenario, you can chump the snake with like some future dork. But the snake is the biggest creature on the board, so.
All right. Well, I hope Sanders likes drawing cards, because he got to draw about 3 extras this game.
Cracking the clue. We want to be sure. Still had all these. Looks like he draws another land. Can only play one per turn, though. We're going to go down on Liliana. And rebuy a Noxious Gear Hulk, it looks like. Just to be sure. You can never be too careful here. Let's see if he realizes that he has the win.
All right, there it is.
He's done it, folks. He's turned creature sideways and is now victorious.
Fantastic. So I think there was a direct correlation to the number